let's go to talking about the Twitter hacker. So for those who don't know, on July 15th, Twitter was hacked. And the hacker posted on accounts of people like Joe Biden, Elon Musk, and many Apple, and many other big brands' verified accounts. The message was pretty similar, saying that we are feeling generous, send some amount to this Bitcoin address, we'll send the double back, which is obviously a scam. Although a lot of people fell for it. And the initial investigation revealed that Twitter's internal tools were used. So it is kind of hard to hack each of these very
high-profile
people at the same time. Mm-hmm. Yeah, high-profile people at the same time.
Right.
So when it was happening, it was pretty clear it was done from the inside, Twitter. The gist of it is, every social media company has these support tools which they require to manage all the accounts and provide support to people.
Mm-hmm.
And these tools are pretty common in organizations because they have to control what's happening on the platform. Right. So if someone gets hacked, high profile gets hacked, the profile needs to be returned to that person because they are verified and they have connections basically at this point. And these tools are kind of like the god mode of Twitter. They can be used to do anything. If you want to delete Elon Musk's account, you can do it with one click. If you want to do this, do that.
So essentially you can use that to tweet also. Tweet anything you want from Elon Musk's account.
You can tweet anything you want. You can read anyone's DMs. You can do anything.
Yeah. So 15 July, right?
So the hack happened on 15 July, and I saw it happen live.
Yeah, same. So on 15 July, I'm just gonna sum it up. 15 July ko both high profile logo ke accounts hack hue. The account sub mein se ek hi tweet aaya ki tum humko paise bhejo.
It was similar tweet. Yeah.
A similar tweet. Matlab sirf the Bitcoin address was different, right? Yeah, even a few wordings.
There were two Bitcoin addresses in.
हाँ, so essentially what tweet ने ये बोला कि तुम हमको Bitcoin भेजो, हम तुमको double Bitcoin वापस भेजेंगे, and all of these were like millionaires and billionaires who tweeted this out, and a lot.
So person who doesn't know a lot about fake news, it seemed pretty legit because these are billionaires.
Yeah, these are billionaires
and finally they took Mr. Beast's account.
Oh,
and this is one guy who anyone can believe that this guy can do because he does all this stuff anyway.
I did not know that Mr. Beast also got hacked. Holy shit.
He got, and the tweets were basically, okay, now it's done, because the one person who believe will do something like this is Mr. Beast.
Right.
He can pretty much return everyone's Bitcoin and double the amount, because if it's just 100k or so,
that's
right. Videos are normally so much more.
That's right. But
Mr. Beast, come on.
Yeah, man. I think the only red flag in those tweets were, the biggest red flag in those tweets were that they had a Bitcoin address. That's the biggest red flag. At least for people who are even mediocrely informed about the tech world. Even like, sabko pata hai aajkal Bitcoin kya hai. Like, bahut logo ko nahi pata hai. But I think that's
the biggest. Don't send money to something you don't trust using an untraceable currency.
But people don't know that it's untraceable. But then again, if
Bitcoin,
if you can use Bitcoin, that then you would know what Bitcoin is.
You untraceable.
Yeah. Oh man.
Anyway, so the person who was caught, his name is Graham Ivan Clark, and he is a 17-year-old who hacked Twitter.
Oh man.
Twitter.
Too good.
Is the Bay Area one of the most biggest company? They have security protocols in place and everything.
Hacked by a 17-year-old. Holy shit. Man,
exactly.
Now I understand why all these stars in US rom-coms, in Riverdale and stuff, they all look so grown up, even at the age of 17, because they are super grown up. I'm seeing a picture of Graham right now, and he does not look 17, all right? And I don't think he looks 17 at all. He looks 24, 25, dude, I swear.
I like you with
that. Yeah, exactly. And it's just my observation ki, like, most of the TV series that are based in, that star Caucasian stars, लाइक मैं रिवरडेल का एग्जांपल दे रहा हूँ कि रिवरडेल में दे सपोज टू बी इन हाई स्कूल, दे सपोज टू बी 17 18 ईयर ओल्ड्स, बट दे डोंट लुक 17 18 नॉर डू दे डू थिंग्स लाइक दे 17 18 ऑलराइट, दैट्स व्हाट आई एम सेइंग कि
ओके
या व्हाइट पीपल जस्ट या व्हाइट पीपल जस्ट लुक ओल्डर देन दे आर मैन, इट्स वेरी कंफ्यूजिंग.
Okay, coming back to his history, he started playing Minecraft when he was 10 to escape the family, unhappy family home. His parents got divorced when he was 7.
Mm-hmm.
And by the age of 15, he had joined hacker groups. And by the age of 16, he had started, like 1 year before 16, he had started scamming people for Bitcoin.
Damn, just last year, holy shit.
Yeah, so a couple of points about him. He's being prostituted along with two other people who were helping him do this hack.
Mm-hmm.
And he's being charged with 30 felonies. Even though he is a minor, in the Florida state law says that if the hack or any crime has money involved in it, they can be prosecuted as adults.
Oh man.
So,
but I mean, it's high time we stopped prosecuting on the basis of age anyways.
Exactly. And so his journey started with scamming people for Minecraft skins or etc. It's capes, skins, whatever the Minecraft community has come on, don't hold me to it.
Essentially,
and
matlab
while
skins,
reading
right?
his, I don't care what it is. While all reading right. his portfolio or something like that, I realized he's really good at social engineering. Most of
yeah.
the stuff he did
yeah.
in,
was interacting
didn't
with people.
High level computer stuff. He was just good at making people give the money first and then not send the skin or something like that.
Smart. That's exactly how business is done. You convince people. That's the biggest power of a businessman.
And he was kicked from the hacker firm's OG users when he failed to pay bitcoins to someone who had already sent him money. But even after that happening, he somehow harnessed the group to find a way to take over people's SIM card so that they can take all the cards. So this technique is called SIM swapping. What you do is you call the telecom operator. Yeah, so you call the telecom operator. Someone, I want to hack Atik. So I'll call his telecom operator saying that I am Atik. I have lost my phone. Please deactivate my SIM card. I'll come and get the new SIM card. And they'll provide fake ID KM Atik. They'll go to their SIM card office. They'll take a number. Uske se saying ki maine hi deactivate karwaya tha. They'll take the same number back.
But
and then
won't they ask
forgot
for
my
like
password,
a...
send the OTP to the phone. Yeah, identity. How hard is it to fake your Aadhaar card? I'll just print your Aadhaar card, put my photo on it. Who's checking if photo or naam ka match ho raha hai?
That's right.
So it's not that hard to take your phone number. This
That's
technique
right.
is called SIM swapping.
Yeah, it is.
And
it is.
In 2019, these hackers, along with Crowd, took control of a phone of a tech investor in Seattle area. His name is Greg Bennett. And they took 164 of his bitcoins within minutes. They took his SIM card and within minutes, they had all his bitcoins and all his accounts.
Holy shit.
And the amount then was $856,000.
Oh man.
And currently they could be worth $1.8 million.
My god.
So when this happened, Bennett contacted the Secret Service and they
Secret Service actually.
Before that So before what happened is Bennett got a extortion note from one of the hackers. His name was Krim. He was working along with Clark.
Okay.
And the note says, give us a reminder of the money which is left in the account to Bittrex. So they weren't even hiding or something like that. I mean, if you steal someone's bitcoins, Pura, you won't be hiding. But they had the audacity to send a message saying, send us the remainder of it. We have all your accounts. You don't have any other way to escape.
Damn.
And
balls.
In April, the secret service confiscated 100 bitcoins from Clark and I guess sent them back to
Bennett.
Mr. Bennett. I don't know about that.
Let's
but
see.
This was a big hit for Clark.
It was.
100 of his bitcoins were confiscated. And by that time, he had a home. He had his own BMW Series 3 or something like that.
Wow, man.
And stuff. So he was doing pretty well. But the Secret Service seizing his Bitcoins was a big shake for him. Although, less than 2 weeks after that, he started devising or finding a way to get into Twitter. And again, he didn't use any special tech. I mean, social engineering is a pretty hard thing to do.
It is, definitely. Because people
but
are very complex.
Technical.
Right?
Yeah, people are complex, but then you have to fool so many people at once if you're
That's
trying
right.
to get into Twitter. So what happened was he tricked a Twitter employee into thinking that he's one of his co-workers and then got the access to the customer service portal. So to do what he did to Twitter, not only do you require the customer service portal, but you need access to internal networks and then another
of course, more
credentials.
Admin
rights or something like that.
Yeah, right.
But since he was in the customer service portal, he knew who had those rights. And then he went on to take those credentials using further social engineering.
Damn.
And so starting with what he did is, he sold Twitter accounts. Like at W and stuff as a 3-letter Twitter accounts, 4-letter Twitter accounts.
Some
he
do.
Sold them on the black market because he had the systems in place to take the accounts from these other users.
Barabar.
So he would take the account from other users and then sell it on the black market.
Wow.
But later what he started doing was, he sold the account and then used the Twitter tools again to boot those users out of the account.
Damn.
So
just
taking
it's
money
a cycle.
And then
holy
continuous
shit.
Cycle. Yeah,
damn.
Exactly.
That's crazy.
And then he did the infamous Twitter hack. Hacking all the major high-profile accounts and stuff. So, how did a 16-year-old end up doing this? That's the biggest question everyone is asking. Like, how is he so good at it? That he pretty much went into Twitter. He got his way around a lot of stuff, like swim, shopping, yes, sir. And, I don't know, all this seems like it started from childhood trauma, right? Parents getting divorced and an unhappy family home. And when his friends and other online colleagues were contacted, they all mentioned that he was pretty short-tempered. He would have swings of moods, like angry, sick, happy and stuff. And yeah, I guess that's about it. Yeah, I don't have any more points, I guess. But it's just that, be safe, guys. There are smart 17-year-olds and who can get into Twitter.
That's
it's
right.
just that if he had made the right career choice and stuff, because honestly, he's good at what he does.
Dude, imagine.
It would have been an amazing career.
Oh my God, seriously. Imagine if this guy had a good family background. He could have been capable of so many
exactly.
things.
And
holy shit.
Although,
man.
Although seeing the portfolio of other hackers, similar smart hackers, they have all been to jail. Like they do stuff, they go to jail and then they come out, then some cybersecurity firm pays them a lot of amount to do what they anyway like to do.
Nice.
So I guess he's going on that path again. It's a common path in cyber. It's
right.
just that high profile hackers go that path pretty often.
It suits.
Nice. Although no one knows what's going to happen and he's being charged as a adult,
as a major, not a minor.
Yeah, sorry. Minor. Yeah, not a minor.
Bad terminology.
Oof.
But yeah, what do we learn from this? Raise your kids right. That's what we learn from this. Or if you're not
raise your kids right.
And if you're not raising your kids right, don't give them computers. Best.
Yeah.
Oh man.
Kakanda advisor.
Make sure sorry guys. This is not an advice podcast.
So you're troubling them, you're not even giving them computers.
This is not an advice podcast. This is
a news
analysis
case,
podcast.
I guess.
Yeah, this obviously doesn't happen
just,
a lot.
It's just that it's not about how he did it. It's about Twitter also.
Definitely.
How
it's about
did
Twitter.
Something like this slip up.
Definitely it's about
and,
Twitter.
And they have been investigating a lot and stuff has been going down. They are securing everything. They have limited some functionality as of now, but they are looking into a lot of it.
Yeah, man, I hope this doesn't happen again.
I know. Although Twitter got off cheaply, that is what I would say. The thing is,
what do you think would have happened? What more do you think would have happened?
If someone with a certain, this guy didn't have any intent, he just wanted Bitcoins. But someone, this was a 17-year-old kid. Imagine what a state or some other organization of very skilled hackers could have done to Twitter. They could have single-handedly taken down Twitter in one night.
They could have taken
down Agnes Sugota, and Twitter is just a mess, and it is too hard to clean up for anyone. It's just that Twitter got off cheap.
Twitter got off cheap.
Any security expert would have taken millions if he had found this.
Right, this kid
went off with like 170,000 bitcoins, and that too was not Twitter's money. It was money sent by other people.
So it's a saying it's a big deal that Twitter still works right now.
It's a big deal Twitter got off this easy.
Agar
ye koi aur state karta, state or any hacker group, Twitter would have been a mess.
Like you couldn't send tweets, you couldn't send DMs, just in functional.
It's not about not sending DM. It's about what's the point of sending things. Jab pura Twitter hi vandalized.
Na wohi to bol raha hu na, the app wouldn't work at all. Like
it would work. It's just that Elon Musk's first 10,000 tweets is now send Bitcoin to this address. Who's gonna clean that up? Saying that Elon Musk, Trump ka wo hai ki I'm launching nukes on North Korea. So North Korea is in all panic mode and there are nukes being sent everywhere. Like,
right.
Just like Donald Trump announced ki I'm banning TikTok, if he would have announced ki, if not he, some other state hacker or stuff would have used his account to announce we are launching nukes or something.
Nukes on China.
Although,
trigger World War III.
I have to mention this. The president of US, Donald Trump, and there is this at POTUS, president of the United States of America. These accounts have special protections in place. So even though he got in to Twitter to that level to attack Apple, Elon Musk, Joe Biden and everyone, these accounts, Donald Trump ka and president of the United States,
have
special protections in just these two accounts, just president ka. Two have special protections so that they can't be hacked.
He's like the commander of the forces and stuff. Yeah, I say kaise thodi usko kisi ko bhi na. There has to be an extra layer of like government security or whatever stuff.
I have no clue about that. It's just that that is why they couldn't be hacked. Varna they could have been available as they wanted.
That's nice.
So be safe, guys. If you build tech companies, make safer tools.
If you build tech
companies.
Every day in India, we are making tech companies. This is this is a message for all of them.
Anyway, that's about it on my coverage of Twitter. Just keep looking out for stuff, guys. And don't send Bitcoins to anyone if you don't trust them.
Don't
especially
Twitter. Yeah, especially from Twitter. Just don't do it.